I really feel bad for Florida right now because this is heading straight towards them. The first image in this slideshow starts off by showing Florida, the coastline highlighted, and how high the water is supposed to rise in the short foreseeable future. And the second slide shows the horrifying satellite imagery of Hurricane Milton, which is barreling straight for them. And right now, Florida just can't catch a break. Recently, we've had Hurricane Helene, which has cost billions of dollars in damage and taken hundreds of lives. And now they're about to be hit by Hurricane Milton, which many people are saying is going to be the most powerful storm Florida's seen in 100 years. And right here, you can see its path going directly through Florida. Last night, Hurricane Milton was deemed as a Category 5 hurricane with winds of 180 miles per hour. Currently, it's sitting at 155 miles per hour, but this is still a Category 4 and very deadly. It's thought Milton will make landfall either Wednesday or Thursday, so if you live in this area, leave now.
PM number, once again, 165 mile per hour winds. Yeah, back up to a Cat 5. Cat 5 on the Saffir-Simpson wind scale, and it's actually now called the wind scale. If you're an old timer like me, it used to be just the Saffir-Simpson scale, and it had the winds, it had the pressure, and it had storm surge kind of categorized on it. And we've learned over time that they're not always the same. And so this just the wind scale, a Cat 5 starts at 157, and there's no top end to it. So yesterday at 180, it was still a Cat 5. But it's that Cat 5 now at 165. 905 is the pressure, and that eye obviously looks very, very good right now. So here's that 5 p.m. forecast track. You can see turning to the northeast, finally starting that turn today line, because what happened earlier today, it was on the right side of the line. And so instead of coming up like this, it's coming up like that right now. And so that shifted it. So the track ended up coming down towards Sarasota because of that. So eyewall replacement cycle. Look at that, guys. Not much of an eye there that you could see. Wow, that is impressive. 165 mile per hour winds around there. They've been talking about all kinds of turbulence, as you can imagine, for the hurricane hunters that are out.
Hurricane Milton, you will learn to fear the Lord. I want to give all the honor, glory, and praise to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rawakha Kodash, double honor to the elders at Great Millstone, top of the true, single honor to the elect, peace and blessings to the one-third, and confusion of faces in the four corners of the earth, Shalom. As you can see, man, this is a very intense hurricane, stemming from Category 5, you know, possibly, it could be a Category 3. You know, when the landfall, when the touchdown. And the reason why I'm making this video, because Helene just slipped by us. I live in Tampa, you know, slipped by us going north in the Gulf. And we got some heavy rain, y'all. Heavy rain. It was flooding. It was flooding throughout, you know, wasn't terrible. But it was still flooding enough that people's cars got flooded out. My mom's car got totaled out. And my brother's car got totaled out. Right? The reason why I'm making this is because last week people were crying and complaining about having to work on a Saturday. I was disgusted. Not at the fact we had to work. At just how ungrateful they were. When I'm at my job, I always try to have a positive energy, like Paul say, if at all possible, be at peace with all men. I say my cliche terms. Hey, well, God bless. All right, brother, get home safe. See you tomorrow. I say it all the time. All the time. Whether it's raining, whether it's daytime, whether there's a thunderstorm, whether it's perfect weather, I always have the same energy, right? To an extent, of course, we're human. But now that this hurricane is barreling towards us, I mentioned it to people. I said, see, y'all, I said, people were complaining and crying about having to come in to work. There are people who don't even have a house to go to, nor a job to go to, you know, to provide for their family anymore. And y'all was complaining about work. And now all of a sudden, lo and behold, look what's coming our way. This is Psalms 83, 14 through 16. As the fire burneth a wood, and as the flame set of the mountains on fire, so persecute them with thy tempest, and make them afraid with thy storm. Fear the faces with shame, that they may see thy name, O Lord. O Yahweh, I should say. So let that sink in. Persecute them with thy storm, thy tempest. Tempest is like a tornado or a hurricane. And make them call upon you. And see, that's the thing, though. Like in Proverbs, the first chapter, when it said, the Lord said, you wanted none of my reproof. You said you wanted none of his counsel, meaning you didn't want to listen to the prophets. The Lord said, therefore, I will laugh at your calamity. Scary feat, y'all. It's a very scary feat to understand. When the mother nature will remind you just how feeble you are. There's a higher power. Her name is Yahweh. I know people use mother nature, whatever, but it's really the Most High doing it. The Most High is controlling all aspects of life. So, like I said to a Jay, I don't even know him. I was like, hey, I said, I hope to see all of you again. Oh, no, nah, no hope. No, you will. You will. No, nah, you will. See, I can understand being optimistic, but I'm realistic. Because like I would ask anyone, especially people who say they don't believe in God, did you have a say-so the day you was born? None of us did. So how the hell you know you gonna see me the next day, sir? Or the next day, sir? Or the next day, sir? You understand what I'm saying? That's why it's always good to be humble. Because I say, I hope to see y'all. You know what I'm saying? Or I say, get home safe so I can see your ugly face tomorrow, jokingly. Man, some people, man, there are hundreds of people still missing in North Carolina. People are still reeling back from what Helene just did. And now here comes another hurricane. Can't catch a break, right? Me and Mondoose went to the park a couple days ago, go walking. Literally, it's this neighborhood called Shore Acres, so you know it's by the water. Literally, every house, this is where, you know, the Edomites live. Nice area, too. Every house had debris in front of it. Just miscellaneous debris. It was crazy. You would have thought they were doing remodeling on every house. And that was just from the little water we got. Now we're finna get a direct hit with water and wind. And this is why I said, you will learn to fear the Lord, man. But like the Lord say in the Bible, in Isaiah, why must you be stricken anymore? You will revolt more and more. Really talking about Israel, but it's just people in general. You're going to go right back to your wickedness when hurricane season's over. Ain't nothing going to change. But this is Sirach or Ecclesiasticus, a part of the 1611 King James Version Bible. This is Sirach or Ecclesiasticus, chapter 5, verse 7. Make no tarrying to turn to the Lord, and put not off from day to day. For suddenly shall the wrath of the Lord come forth, and in thy security thou shalt be destroyed, and perish in the day of vengeance. So, listen, it says, make no tarry to turn to the Lord and put it not off from day to day. In other words, you think you have time. Don't procrastinate, because the Lord will come visit you in your security. Think about security. Don't you? I mean, will you feel secure, you know, with like $100,000 in the bank? You know, will you feel secure with your doors locked when you go inside your house? Right. Don't you feel secure with your seatbelt on when you're driving? Secure gives you comfortability, right? Safety. The Lord said he will visit you in your safety, in your comfortability. He will take it from you. He's doing, the Lord would do that with natural disaster, hurricanes, tornadoes, landslide, mudslide, flash flood, earthquakes, tsunamis, avalanches. The Lord will open up a hole in the earth, sinkholes. Like, come on, man. Blizzards. Man, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai is to be feared, man. There is a power on earth. There is a power on heaven and heaven and earth. Not gonna make this long, but I saw this article and I had to include this also. It says Hurricane Milton is so insanely powerful. It's literally just a giant red smudge on meteorological maps. Let me tell you something. I'm from St. Pete, St. Petersburg, Florida. Let me show you on the map. So this is Pinellas County. All right, look at it. Pinellas County is a peninsula. For those who don't know, a peninsula is where a body of land is surrounded by three sides. So it's not an island. All right. The south, the east, and the west are all surrounded by water. Only thing that connects Pinellas County to Sarasota is the bridge, the Sunshine Bridge or the Skyway Bridge, depending on what you want to call it. Right. This is where I live at. This is where I lived at, right? And I was born, well, not born. I was living right here. You see where it says St. Petersburg right here? You have to put this into your perspective, people. This is Florida's already a peninsula. This is a peninsula inside of a peninsula. This small piece of land. You see that piece of land right there? You see that piece of land right there, right? Let me show you something. Now, look at the trajectory of where Milton is going. The trajectory. Wow. That little piece of land. If they make a 2025 map of Florida, I don't even know if Pinellas County would be on there. And I'm not being funny or being facetious, but this is another reason why you will learn to fear the Lord. Man, oh man. Koholoyin la Yahweh Bashim Yahushai Bashim Rukhakadash. Now, I want to read a little bit of this article. It says the hurricane, which emerged as a tropical storm in the Gulf of Mexico over the weekend, expected to make landfall on the western coast of Florida Wednesday evening, was declared an epic Category 5 hurricane yesterday after rapidly intensifying in the Gulf. The verbiage in this article really goes into detail on what is going on. It says, epic. The scale of the... Forgive me. You probably can't hear what I was saying. The scale of the storm is staggering. Wind speeds have topped a treacherous 180 miles per hour. With sustained gusts of over 200 miles per hour. Over 1 million Floridians were urged to evacuate. Let that sink in, people. 180 miles per hour. Have you ever been driving and going at least 45 miles per hour? You felt that, right? Now, have you ever been on a highway going like 65 miles per hour? I'm talking with your windows down. Right? I've had my windows all the way down going at least 85 in my car. And I just know like that wind, just that power. That's from 85 miles per hour. This is 180 miles per hour at a Cat 5, even though it's being reduced down to 155 miles per hour. That's still twice as fast as me going 80 on the interstate. Just let that sink in, people. And that's just the wind I'm passing by. There's going to be debris going at that speed. A straw could be a deadly missile. It could be a deadly projectile that could pierce your heart and kill you instantly. Yeah, this is very epic. You will learn to fear the Lord. And I'm making this for the people out there that want to pray I love my mom, but mom, you want to pray when things get bad. You want to joke all the time when things are good. This is why I'm always serious, mom. I've been doing it since 2013, going out preaching. I ain't never stopped. I'm telling my mom this, you know. This is why I still do what I do, mom. You know. But anyhow, you know, women is different. So in here, I want to read this quote. It says, quote, I am at a loss for words to meteorologically describe to you the storm, small I in intensity. Bergeron wrote, this hurricane is nearing. Listen to what he said, y'all. This hurricane is nearing the mathematical limit of what Earth's atmosphere over this ocean water can produce. That is damn right petrifying. Think about this, y'all. He's saying, out of all of the energy, all the hot, warm water in the Gulf of Mexico, out of all the metrics of the atmosphere and the pressure, this is the most intense that this hurricane could possibly get on Earth. And it's coming for us. This is nothing short of astronomical. I am at a loss for words, like you said, to meteorologically describe you the storm, small I in intensity. 897 barometers? Pressure, forgive me. With 180 miles per hour max sustained winds and gusts 200 miles per hour. This is now the fourth strongest hurricane ever recorded by pressure. The fourth strongest ever recorded. Man, Koho Loyan Lagi Haba Shemya Shaba Shemru Kakadash. I'm about to close out. This is Sirach or Ecclesiasticus, chapter 2, verse 16 through 18. They that fear the Lord will seek that which is well, pleasing unto him, and they that love him shall be filled with the law. They that fear the Lord will prepare their hearts and humble their souls in his sight, saying, we will fall into the hands of the Lord and not to the hands of men, for as his majesty is, so is his mercy. Now, the Lord orchestrates life and death. The Lord wounds and heals. The Lord creates these disasters, things like that, right? So man can help you. You're stranded. You need electricity, you need transportation, you need shelter. But man can't save you from the Lord. That's the difference. That's what I'm trying to get at. U.S. Coast Guards, you know, man, just all the Salakia. That was my dudes calling me, you know, worrying about me and my three brothers. I'm like, man, chill out, man. You know, I'm bucking down. Other brother, he in the shelter. He could have came and stayed with me. He didn't want to. Fine, I don't care. Other brother, he with his friends, whatever. And my other brother, he at his house, whatever. So we everybody fine, you know. Anyways, yeah. So it's you can. How should I say this? The Bible says, "Vain is the help of man," but if you're stranded and the U.S. Coast Guard come help you, that's beautiful. That's not vanity. That's helpful. What I'm saying is, man can't save you from the Lord. That's what I'm getting at. The man cannot save you from the Lord. The Lord is the only one that can save you, you know. But anyways, nonetheless, I ain't want to make this too long. That being said, pray you was edified, fed, stay in the spirit, don't fear it, just endure it. Ask for forgiveness, pray without ceasing, stay humble, remain diligent. Kwame Sha'ala, Mafla Baba. Shalom.